Ready to begin with our next session, which is on future of power plant digital twin, predictive and prescriptive analytics. For this, we have Mr. Sandeep Pawar, solution consultant, digital transformation, APAC at Honeywell. Welcome, Mr. Pawar.
Hi, Achal. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Yes, I can see you also. Thank you. I'm going to quickly introduce you to the audience and then you can begin sharing your presentation. Mr. Pawar has more than 15 years of experience working at Honeywell. In engineering roles, he has executed various MES and digital transformation projects for many global companies for over 10 years. His key areas of expertise are enterprise data platform, APM, operation management, planning, scheduling, and performance management. Mr. Pawar, this session is for about 20 minutes, so we'll request to keep your presentation short for about 15 minutes, so we have time for some Q&A.
Okay, sure. I'll try and wrap it as fast as possible, so as for the, are you able to see my share?
I am. If you could just move it to full screen, and I think we'll be good to go. Yes, great.
Okay, thanks Achal for the short introduction, and thanks everybody for attending the sessions and also giving Honeywell opportunity to present where we are thinking. We are moving in the direction for digital twin, and I heard a lot of speakers on assets. So I want to keep this session because small session. So maybe a use case I thought would be a good one to share with our relevant experience. So it might click to a lot of people who are really operating that and can really make a value out of it. So use case is going to be an HRSG use case. So Honeywell Forge, the solution which we talk, is a new platform which Honeywell is providing in the space of digital transformation. It's a both cloud agnostic as well as an on-prem kind of a platform, which essentially has four main pillars. One is enterprise platform, other is people, third thing is process, and fourth one is worker. Since it's a platform, it also gives us the capability that we are able to hinge third-party solutions also, like you already have some kind of machine learning algorithm, you already have some kind of simulation engine, steady state, dynamic models you already created. The platform itself provides you opportunity to integrate those solutions and not essentially only get stuck with Honeywell solution. So as a part of the solution, today we will be covering enterprise performance management. And in that also, what we would be looking up is a day in the life of a power engineer who is looking up to the entire portfolio of the asset and performance process part of it. Eventually, I'll also touch base like how it forms one of the important part of the overall performance management using a digital twin. So any power engineer, he comes, and this example which I am sharing is also it's a live example which we have recently occurred with in one of our captive power plant in one of the big refineries in India, and hence it is all real data you see, real value you see. I'll not say data, real value you see, and not something which is in some kind of simulation or a marketing document. So he comes in the morning, he sees how his asset performance or how his process is performing today. He has a morning meeting to attend on daily basis. And first thing he goes is he comes to his desk, he sees his screen and he sees, is everything happening correctly or has any disturbance occurred or is occurring currently. And for that, he deploys the digital twin insight to get into tool. So he sees a tool, he sees the heat map. Now this heat map actually gives him the whole plethora of all the different assets, different processes involved. He quickly jump into, he can quickly have an insight of different areas, how they are performing. The largest square indicates that more critical assets are there. The color indicates that critically, there's a higher criticality or higher priority assigned to it. He quickly sees that there is some disturbance in the HRSG, which is heat recovery for steam generation area. And he wants to get into the details of it. He quickly clicks onto it. He comes to this screen. The screen actually gives him immediately the bad actors. What were the bad actors? He gets a quick insight on the efficiency part of it. And the most important thing is it's not only giving him the problem, it is also giving him the prescriptions. Now, this is an active fault on the chef side of that. You need to take an action, maybe an inspection can be planned. But now this is the first primary information which is getting, you need to deep dive, understand more. So the solution or the software in modern eras should not only tell them the problem, because you know those customers are well versed with the problem. They are looking extra. They are investing money, so they want to get the exposure and experience which companies bring. And Honeywell is one of the companies which brings a lot of this domain expertise, which we have this pre-built libraries or can have this pre-built prescription, which can really help them to take decision. And once a prescription gets popped out, which tell him to do an inspection. Now, he wants to further dig dive, understand. Now, this was an asset view. We want to see a dashboard view. What is the problem which he sees? And quickly, in one glance, he can see that all his KPIs, the HRSG efficiency is good, the cohesion efficiency is good. So asset-wise, he's sorted. What he sees a problem is steam to fuel ratio, which is very less. And why it is happening when your assets are doing good. So in the whole process picture, this is not making sense to him. And hence come the solution which Honeywell provides, and a hybrid solution. So the case which I just shared, you can very clearly see my assets are really doing good. What is happening is steam to fuel ratio failure. So fuel is also going good to the HRSG, but what is happening, the steam is going low. And that's the reason this drop in the steam to fuel ratio is happening. And that's a unique solution which Honeywell provides, is we bring best of both the world. A lot of people currently will solve this problem using the first principle model, which is a thermodynamic model, which will calculate efficiency. So I have my asset efficiency, which will calculate the process behavior. So all my critical KPIs. So both these pictures are doing really good. I see that my asset is really working perfectly fine. Now, none of my efficiencies and KPI are dropping. Then what's the problem? Then I can turn to another solution or another part of the solution, which is advanced pattern recognition, which is basically deploying the machine learning algorithm. Because in the plant, there can be some things which can be really binded by equations or binded by experience, but there will be certain things which would be only make sense when data comes into picture. So I can then look into the advanced pattern recognition, and both of these things are put to a rule-based diagnostic. So, you know, a rule governs both these things, and the output of this together gives me, makes sense that, oh no, how I should react to this particular problem, or how should I react to this anomaly. So anomaly detection is the core for any digital twin solution. And Honeywell does this using two distinct technologies. One is the first principle-based engine or a simulation-driven engine. So companies can have use technologies which has pre-built equations and find the critical KPIs, or they can also have their own simulation engines. Like most of the power plant, because they have a lot of mandates, 80% of them would already have some kind of simulation engine already, or operator training engine already used, or it is just lying in some corner. This is what Honeywell brings to the table. You can reutilize it, you can make value out of it, and maybe use that steady state, or we use those models to also do the performance monitoring. And the second digit part of the digital twin would be the data analytics model, which is governed by machine learning. So you have a prediction, you do a prediction of the behavior of the data from 1 year, 2 years, or whatever amount of time you have stored. And then you actually put it in the detection mode using Python. Honeywell has its own native libraries. You can bring neurals, DeepForest, so many techniques are available. Honeywell platform, as I mentioned in the start, a digital platform which gives you an option to inbuild all your own libraries also. So if you already have a SureSense library, you already have a Python library, bring it, add it into the software, and put it as one of the inputs or governing data model to the whole process. Find the root causes, find the fault symptom, get an early detection. So you see the use case I am sharing, wherein the first principle part of it is not making any sense, because everything is perfectly, the cohesion efficiency was good, the power to flow rate was good. What was not happening was the fuel to steam issue. So does data model need to be deployed to check it? So coming back to my use case, the power engineer sees all kinds of KPIs. He sees the feed rate, it is good. He sees GT. Gas turbine fuel is good, HRSG mass flow is good, inlet temperature is good. So what is the problem? Then he comes and see that one of the KPI, which is steam to fuel ratio, it's bad. Your limit is 45, it's showing a 44 value. And again, alert would be generated to him. He sees that at since 9:37 a.m., he's having this issue, which is leading to a poor performance of your HRSG and hence a poor performance at the HRSG overall level or at that plant level. So now what he does, he comes to another stream or another module, which is the machine learning algorithm which Honeywell provides. So in this screen, if you see this part is nothing but the health index. This health index is governed by data under various operating modes. This lower screen gives him the root cause or the variables which are disrupting the overall process. So he sees one of the possibilities which he sees that the controller can't compensate. There is a spike in a health index. A health index, in case in terms of Honeywell, you can say that you have your expected value based on your predicted model. You also have your actual value coming from your DCS or historian. A comparison of these two, if it goes within the accepted sigma deviation, then you can say that both should be equal. So anything which is near one can be assumed a good health index. A good health index is indicated by a number, a statistical number. It comes after a lot of internal calculation, but for a layman, it is one. One is the best number. So anything, the graph is near one is good. But he sees that there is a sudden spike in these numbers, which is occurring. And what is the issue? Then it also gives you the four important root cause variable. First, it says the feed to the total HRSG system. Second, it says the mass flow. Third, temperature. Fourth, pressure. So it is arranging. Now, since it is bringing the steam output flow as one of the points, you may be able to doubt that is it because of steam trap or is it because the flow meter itself is wrong. So the Honeywell application provides you that same model can have multiple modes. So we created another model which essentially doesn't consider the flow. You know, the flow makes the things very obvious. In this, I don't have the flow. I can see the same behavior coming. The prediction model is giving me the similar behavior even without the flow. But now it is telling me the pressure is the main culprit, like the highest contributor is pressure. And now it makes sense. You can start making sense now. My steam to fuel ratio is bad because my pressure is dropping. The steam pressure is dropping, which is the highest root cause variable. And a potential cause for this can be a tube leakage or a crack or a seal leakage, which is happening, which is leading to this problem. So in the overall process picture, I have validated, the engineer has quickly validated that there is no issue as such. Because of my performance or because of my operating conditions, all the problem it is being caused is because of my mechanical failure, and that's totally detected. And that was how detected. So what that engineer does it, he needs to do a field review. He needs to plan or generate a request for a field review. So in the whole life cycle of our solution, he did the online monitoring, he did the predictive monitoring. Then it also has a reliability angle to it. In the reliability angle, what he does is another solution, which is called Honeywell Field Inspection Round. He generates a field request for a field operator to go and check if there is some kind of leakage which is happening. He immediately SMS or email goes on the handle device of the field operator, where it has already has a pre-built checklist. It already has a pre-built functionality to take the photo. And he can also deploy another technology which Honeywell provides. It's called a worker assist, which is nothing but a helmet on his top. So he sees a notification on his mobile, he quickly goes to the field. And there he sees that the flange, the steam output flange, where it is getting connected to a major steam line, is having a leakage. So now you can see a very scientific approach was followed. A very methodically, he ruled out the performance or asset issue. He was zeroed down to mechanical issue. He thinks tube leakage is one of the issues which is causing this. He sends his field operator. Field operator sees there's a leakage happening, quickly takes a photograph, sends it back to the engineer. The software provides you the capability that it can use any kind of CMMS application like IBM Maximo or SAP HANA. So he immediately, based on the input which is provided to him by the helmet, he raised a maintenance request either in SAP HANA or in IBM Maximo that quickly this has to be maintained out. This leakage has to be stopped to avoid. And then this request goes to the maintenance engineer who goes to the field and takes the necessary action. So now if you see, the solution provided you the entire life cycle. It provided you a scientific basis to do a validation, ascertain the problem statement, got a prescription. If you remember, it started with a prescription for inspection of field round. The inspection of field round prescription comes when the software is not able to find any scientific or any logical mathematical base problem in the solution. Then it will obviously ask to be checked this particular thing as a mechanical failure, and prescription generated would be do an inspection of that particular asset. And this completes the whole gambit or whole life cycle in a day of a power engineer. He has sorted this thing. He comes in the morning meeting, which is scheduled at 11 o'clock. The predicted alert helped him to identify a potential failure because the steam ratio didn't go zero. It only went to 44. Expected was 45. So he was able to jump into the problem well in advance, shared in the morning meeting, we had a problem, and in a span of only 1.5 hours to 2 hours. So if you remember, the problem occurred at 9:37 a.m. He had a meeting at 11 a.m. In 1.5 time period, he sorted the problem. He already has requested a maintenance notification or a maintenance work order. So digital twin now has replaced the whole thing. Assume in a normal day, what would have happened? The power engineer would have first struggled. He would have gone through multiple screen, multiple Excel, talked to so many people, talked to reliability, talked to maintenance, talked to production, talk to the operator, then ascertain a problem, then come up with a solution. It would have easily costed him the entire day. And if the crack would have been really serious, could have also led to a trip of that particular HRSG system. So this is how the digital twin is helping engineers in actual live in action to really come ascertain the problem quickly and sort it. Assume a downtime of 4 to 5 hours for a HRSG is a significant amount of capital loss or opportunity loss in case that problem stays. So taking the whole story ahead, when we started this presentation, that performance management is the key in the digital transformation. And one of the part which I today shared was the reliability and availability. Similar kind of capabilities can be applied using various solution, which can be Honeywell, which can be non-Honeywell third party, but we can bring those all kind of solution to a single platform, which is a single source of truth, the Honeywell Forge, which is the platform which provide that capability. To give a right insight to take the right decision on time. That's the key. On time is the key in today's era. When you are investing in such kind of solution, time is the money, and that's how you want to earn out of it. So emission is another big use case. We are working on many of the CPPs or even with some power plants, how the emissions can be brought down or how can they really monitor the emissions. So Honeywell also has some partnership with some camera modules like Rebellion, wherein you can quickly have cameras set up across your plant, and those can give you alert like some kind of gas leakages are happening, especially the greenhouse gas leakages are happening. Those alerts can also come. You can also have, we have partnered with a lot of reliability consulting agencies like MaxScrip and other companies, wherein they can bring their expertise and do a good foolproof reliability FME, RBI, RCM study and bring that part of into the solution. We have a lot of performance monitoring solution which can give you KPI monitoring. So the whole idea is you need to go for a platform. That's what I will recommend. Don't go for a point solution, because this is the time you're investing. If you invest in some point solution, in 2-3 years time, things are changing so rapidly. Everything which is Windows based is turning into cloud based solution, microservices approach. So it already makes sense that you go with a platform based approach. So when a new technology is coming into picture, your platform has that, is ready to handle those new technology, that huge amount of data, which would make sense to you in future. Hence, invest in a platform and then go by, then you can obviously add one by one open source technology, vendor technologies, OEM technologies on that platform. That gives you huge opportunities in future. So finally, driving to autonomous. Autonomy of the solution approach is the whole key to it. You have to autonomize all the input. You need to have multiple models. You need to have data-driven, first principle, AI, computational fluid dynamic, thermographic, lot of different kinds of models are available in the market. The platform should provide you that flexibility to add any. Your domain expertise combined together gives you root causes and actionable insight. That's most important. In the pandemic, one thing you might have seen, all your experienced people, more than 50 years, were asked to stay home and operate through home because in the initial time of pandemic, that they were the most vulnerable. Assume all your experience not available in the plan to take the decision. So you need to capture that knowledge, that prescription, and build it into the system. So even if they are not available, a junior operator, a young guy can get some insight, get some prescription, act upon it quickly instead of waiting, doing phone calls, writing emails to the expert and get an output. And still he may not even get all the insight. So that's the whole key, that the autonomy has to be brought, and digital twin is the way forward for that kind of solution. So I end up, I think it is, the key here is we need to start it today to get result fast, because all these things are data intensive, and the early you get into this, the early insight you start getting into it, the more integration you can achieve, the more analysis you can achieve, and all these things eventually are done to improve the overall process operations. So that's pretty much from my side. I hope I was within the time, Anshul.
Yes. Thank you so much, Mr. Pawar, for a very interesting presentation, taking us through Honeywell solutions for digital twins. We have time for one or two questions. I can see there are questions from the audience, so I'll take those first. Request you to stop sharing your presentation. So yeah, great. The first question is, in which supercritical thermal power plant is this model being implemented or under implementation?
Currently in APAC, I have not idea. It might be done in the other parts, but in Asia Pacific, which I look after, mostly we are doing in captive power plants only associated with refinery. We are in talks with POC with a few of the customers in Singapore, Philippines, but not reveal their names because they are in very early stages. But yeah, we are in talk with thermal power plants and also with geothermal kind of power plants to take the solution and POC. So initially we are entering in the POC, but this solution or use case which I shared was a captive power plant in a refinery.
Thank you. Another question, how is RCA automated?
So RCA itself, root cause analysis itself is driven by data at present. So what we do is all the variables which are associated with that process are considered to be as input to the data analytics model. And when the health index tries to find the deterioration of the health, what it does is it will directly link to the correlated variables. And amongst the correlatable variables, the variable which is, has the highest contribution to that whole deterioration is brought by the solution as a, in the descending order. So that first one, as you saw when I in the use case, I showed you the pressure. So the pressure was the one which was highly contributing to the deterioration. So using that internal weightages or internal routes, it brings them, it orders them in a descending order and automatically finds them based on their influence on the health index. Yeah.
All right. One last question for me. Where do you see this application? Do you see digital twin application across all power plants, or is you think that this is going to be more beneficial for maybe renewable, solar, hydro? Where do you see the taking up going forward?
Okay. Yeah, it's a very good question. In fact, I think in the renewable space, it would be wind, non-renewable fields. It will be, I think wind would be the one wherein you have a lot of this rotating asset, and even geothermal energy, wherein this rotating assets are there. And, you know, the operation has to be well maintained because you don't invest anything on the raw material that Mother Nature gives you. So you only have to monitor this asset properly. And when you have such tools, you can really do a quick maintenance or, you know, fix the problem critically early to avoid any long-term maintenance activity, because in case of this industry, any maintenance activity is total downtime. You know, you don't have an option. If windmill goes down, it goes down. You can't do anything. While in case of a non-renewable power plant, wherein, you know, coal, you might have multiple supercritical turbines running parallelly, you can still churn a few of them to compensate downtime of one of the assets. So I think thermal power plant would be best, thermal, nuclear, all this power plant, anywhere where they already have certain solution in place. The main key message I want to deliver is if they already have some solutions in place, you need to buy a platform, digital twin platform, wherein you can integrate that investment, right? The investment is already done. All of them have some kind of simulation model. That should not go away. So you invest, use that investment, build up on a platform and integrate with some ML AI technique. I can also ensure with my experience, only AI technique will not help. It doesn't give you any sense. You know, it only tells you, as I've given a key use case, 5 are the root cause variable. Only a person sitting behind the screen can make sense that pressure is, why the pressure is high and how you should make sense out of it. So hence, only analytical engines will not give you much insight. You need to combine these two technologies. So if you already have an investment done in any of this, I think it is better you start doing some POCs or getting into those kind of projects wherein you start integrating this to and make more value out of it.
All right. Thank you. Thank you so much, Mr. Pawar, for a very interesting session. And thank you also for sponsoring the conference. Thank you.